What's up, internet? Welcome back once again. I'm Manish from RebellionRadio.com, and today I'm going to do a tutorial on set operators in Oracle SQL. In this tutorial, we will see what union and union all operators are and how to use them along with the restrictions on set operators. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. Set operators allow us to combine rows written from two or more queries. In SQL, we have four set operators: union, union all, intersect, and minus. In this tutorial, we will concentrate over union and union all set operators, and I will explain the remaining set operators in the next tutorial. For the demonstration, I have created and populated two tables, cricket and football. Both of these have two columns, first name and last name. Let's take a quick look at the structure of both these tables along with the data contained by them. Here are the structure of both these tables. As you can see, both the tables have two similar columns, first name and last name, and both these columns share the same data type, which is varchar2. Now let's take a side-by-side look at the data that they are holding. Both these tables have three rows of data, and if you will look carefully, you will notice that there is a duplicate row in both the tables, which is row 1, where first name is Clark and the last name is Kent. You must be wondering why I am telling you this. Don't worry, just sit tight, I'll let you know in a bit. So let's jump over to SQL Developer. And here we are. Now let's do some queries. First, I will demonstrate to you the union set operator of SQL. The union set operator returns result from all the participating queries after eliminating duplication. Let's see the example. Here we have two separate queries. In the first query, we are selecting rows from first name and last name column of cricket table. And in the second query, we are retrieving rows from first name and last name column of football table. And both these queries are bound using union set operator. In this whole operation, union is our operator, and both these queries are operand over which union set operator will work. On executing this query, all the rows of both the columns of both the tables will be returned except the duplicate one. Let's execute and see. Here is our result, and it consists of only 5 rows, not 6, because the row with the duplicate entry, which is Clark Kent, is eliminated. But the same is not true with union all operator, because the union all operator returns result from all the participating queries, including the duplicate rows. This means that if we will execute the same query, then we will get all the rows returned from both the tables along with the duplicate one. Let me demonstrate this to you. For that, I will copy this query and modify it accordingly. Here we go. Now I will change the set operator from union to union all. Okay, done. Let's execute. And as you can see, this time the result set contains 6 rows including the duplicate one. That's the difference between union and union all. Now, there are few things which you should always take care while writing any SQL set queries. Such as number of columns and the column data type written by the query must match. However, the column name can be different. For example, if you see here, both our queries have same number of columns as well as the same data type. Name of the column doesn't matter. This means that even if I swap the current column names, it won't affect the execution of the query. The only thing that should always match are the data type and the number of columns. Let's do another example to further clarify this concept. For this example, I have created another table by the name of demo_emp. This table also has two columns. First is the name with the varchar2 data type, and the second column is age, which is of number data type, as seen in the structure of this table. I have also populated this table, and here are the rows of this table. Let's write a query using this table demo_emp and table football and perform the union set operator. If we try to execute this query, we will get an error because the data type of last name column of the first select statement does not match with the data type of the age column of second select statement. Let's execute. See, I told you error. To solve this error, you can cast the age column of second select statement and make it a character data type. Let me show you. Now execute. This time execution is smooth and successful. Similarly, if number of columns in both the select statements do not match, then also the query results in error. For example, if I delete this age column from the second select statement, let me do it. And now try to execute the query, then I will get an error. This is because in the first select statement we have two columns and in the second select statement we have only one column. Let's execute. See again error. Hope this video helped you in understanding the concept of SQL set operator, especially the union and union all operator. You can download this script, link is in the description box. Please like the video and share it with all your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on my Twitter and Instagram. All the links are in the description box. We'll catch you soon with the second tutorial on SQL set operators. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.